tickets to the Prime Minister or to some high-standing person, they say, I don't care if I lose my job. This is the rules and I have to follow them. Even if my boss, my superior, tells me, bend the rules, he feels bad to bend them. He is forced. Only when he is forced, or he may resign, strict rules. Get in your mind the picture of the strict judge that doesn't want to bend the rules, of the strict teacher that doesn't want to bend the rules, of the politicians bend the rules all the time. You are not a good politician if you don't bend the rules. But of a strict boss, of a strict parent that doesn't want to bend the rules. So, the program. He walks at the street and sees that a young man throws garbage not in the bin but on the street. He cannot help not seeing it and not commending it. What are you doing there? You shouldn't do that. Take it and drop it to the bin. Well, he may not say it if things are a little bit hard, if he see some violent young man that may have a fight and he may punch him if he tells him, what are you doing? But inside he is boiling. You see, the eyes and the mind of Nux Vomica cannot help not seeing what is out of order, either be it a material thing, a program, an ideology, injustice, and everything else. She or he cannot help not seeing, not observing it, and not just observing it, not reacting, not feeling bad. You may have an employee that is Nux Vomica, and if he has the presuppositions and it's top at his work, then he will say that it's in order to be the first and to be the boss, because he is better than the others. But if the upper boss, the top boss, tells that you will be the boss at your office, he may say, this is not correct. John is more, has more qualifications than me, and he is better at this work from me. So he should be the boss. You see, strict rules, strict justice. Not selfishness is not above order, his, while Arsenicum or Lachesis would not have any problem, even if they are not the first. You see, strict rules and strict justice, even against his interest. Strict moral rules. Inside, you have a housewife. Inside the closet, all things, inside the drawers, all things are in perfect order. Perfectionism. Everything must be done in according to the rules and perfect. That's why having all this order and Nux Vomica is a hard-working, by nature, a hard-working person, and is many times a work alcoholic, a workaholic. It has work mania. And many times it is a successful businessman, because he has order, he's hardworking, he's got the brains, he's got the organization. He's a successful businessman. But a very stressed one. Big like that means stress. 3. That means irritability. And when very much stressed, he gets very angry. He's very angry at work when tired. That means he gets very tired, very angry at work, and he goes home and he's very angry and irascible and irritable with his wife and children, because he's tired. Because all other people at work bent the rules and didn't follow the rules and didn't have order, and he comes home and sees the same thing, and by this thing, such a bit click thing, small thing, he gets very angry and he may shout or even be a little bit violent. When he is at the extremes, he tries to button his shirt, and if he cannot do it, then he wants to tear it, or he wants to throw something or break something, but not as much as Stramoni. He bursts easily. This stress causes insomnia. What kind of insomnia? He goes to sleep, he's tired, he's sleepy, but he cannot sleep because he keeps thinking of what he has neglected, the program that he didn't manage to follow, what things he has for the next day. The rhythm of the mind, of the thoughts, doesn't slow down. The function of the brain doesn't slow down. If it doesn't slow down, you cannot sleep. Then if he manages to sleep, and before sleep, each and every noise, even the normal ones, do not let her sleep or make her more angry. And she watches, or he watches the clock and says, it's 1 o'clock in the morning and I can't sleep. I will not be able to get up and be well. I will be tired next morning and I will not follow the program and the schedule. How can I do it if I am tired and sleepy next morning? And this makes me more worried, more stressed, more angry, and insomnia continues. Or something characteristic is that she goes to sleep after some time, and then she wakes up early in the morning, 4, 5, or 6 in the morning, at the meridian. She wakes up, and when she wakes up, she starts thinking about the things she has to do, the jobs she has to do, the tasks she has to do, the duties she has to do next, the day that comes. And although she could sleep until 8 o'clock, she cannot do it. She wakes up, she gets up from the bed and starts doing things, although she's not refreshed. She's tired and sleepy yet. And being so stressed, she may have even a difficulty to sleep, to take a midday nap, because she cannot cope with her schedule. And she's very stressed and cannot sleep, take a nap. This stress causes restlessness to the physical body. Restlessness. Spasms. Twitchings. Tension, muscle tension. This is a great thing for, a great characteristic for nux vomica. Muscle tension all over the body, and especially at the neck and spine. Muscle tension at the neck and spine. Nux vomica feels very tensed, and because these muscles are very strong, she's got this tension. This tension creates headaches, chronic tension headaches, or neuralgias, or dizziness, or vertigo. Dizziness, vertigo, headache, all these kinds of things because of muscle tension at the back of the neck and at the spine, the whole spine. These may also create problems with back pain due to muscle tension or sciatica. This muscle tension, if it has to do with these muscles, the muscles of the stomach and the intestine, because not only the external muscles, but the muscles of the organs are affected, and stomach is a muscle. The intestines are full of muscles. So we have spastic colitis, spastic colitis, constipation, spastic constipation due to tension. She wants to go, she has a program even for her physical functions. Most physical functions are of internal organs are guided by the autonomic nervous system. We have the nervous system is of the central nervous system and the autonomic nervous system. This has to do with external muscles and motion. We give an order, walk, and the muscles obey our will. While autonomic nervous system has to do with autonomic functions, with the heart, with the intestines, with the circulation. We don't control our heart. We don't give orders to our heart to work. When we are asleep, the autonomic nervous system manages to give the orders and to set the rhythm, the tone of the muscles, of the internal organs, in order to do things. The function of the internal organs is autonomic. You cannot give orders. You cannot say, I must have an erection now. I must have, I must stool now. I must urinate now. It has to have its circle and be the time for it. Or else, if you interfere and give orders to functions that are autonomic, you cause imbalance and disorder. That's what happens. Let me give you an example. If lygopodium is very stressed and wants to please his partner and tries to give an order to interferes to the sexual intercourse procedure and says, I will delay to have an orgasm, although I'm at the right time, in order to satisfy my companion, then he will create disorder and he will either have early ejaculation or he will have loose erection. In the same way, Nux Vobica says, the doctor says, said that I should go every day to stool, every morning, because that's the normal and the healthy thing to do. So every day she goes to the toilet, and she may be a person that her organ is not yet ready and has the need for stool every other day or every 3 days. No, she goes to the toilet without having any desire, because she is a spastic personality, a rigid personality, a stressed, a tensed personality, and that's how her organs are also. She has thus spastic intestines. So she doesn't have the desire, she's not, her organism is not ready to stool. She goes to stool and she starts pushing with her belly muscles and with other muscles. And not being ready, then she may have a little bit stool, but she will have an incomplete stool. And she, from the tension, she may create hemorrhoids. She may create problems to the intestines. She may manage to have the opposite result. You see, in order to have stool, you have to follow the wave of muscle spasm that goes like a wave from the small intestine, from the beginning of the large intestine to the rectum. But if you are tensed, you prohibit this wave to go normally. And then, in order to stool, you have to have spasm of the rectum and the opposite of spasm, relaxing to the sphincter of the anus. If you are very tensed, you have spasm to the rectum and spasm to the sphincter. So the door is closed, you push the door in order to go up, you don't open it, the door is closed and locked, and you pushed to go out. No result and problems. If you are relaxed, then you can have the autonomic function go well. Spasm of the rectum, relax of the sphincter, and then you have a normal stool. So, spastic colitis, spastic constipation, and so on. Any other characteristics of Nux Vomica? What makes her angry? Anything that is against order, program, rules, justice, and so on. All these make her angry. Untidiness, lack of program, injustice, and so on. And she expresses, or he expresses, his anger. Fear. Lux vomica doesn't have much of a fear. It's got a lot of stress. That's her fear. Lux vomica, let's say a few general physical characteristics, is cold. It is psoric. Cold 3 or 2. Wears cold 2 or 3, and especially at the head and neck. If she goes out after a bath without drying her hair, then she may get a tension, may get a headache, or she may catch a cold easily catching colds. Desire for spicy food, although she has problems with her stomach, digestion, liver, and intestines. These are the main characteristics and the psychological profile and the essence of Nux Vomica. How about non-verbal data? Let's start first with the structure, the body type and structure of Nux Vomica. I have confirmed again and again that sometimes with being yin, we've got a yin structure, yin body type. That is, we may have a person that is lean, maybe tall or short, it doesn't matter, lean, narrow skeleton, not many muscles, dried up skin, and dried up look. Very worried. It has the appearance of wrinkles due to muscle tension. A very stressed, strict look. Stressful, strict. Very logical, very tensed. And you see a person that is very thin, without any muscles, but although it is like that, it is a very restless person, a very irritable, a very nervous person. A quick person, cannot sit down, wants to do things all the time in order to catch up, to cope with the schedule. Very typical, conservative, not laughing, very typical concerning clothes, the typical tie and costume, formal. Formal outfits, clean-shaven, not extreme things concerning appearance or style, conservative, strict, with the rules, typical, kind, but that typical kindness and politeness. Things as they should be done. Follow the rules. These are the non-verbal characteristics of Nux Vomica. Now, let's go to the Classical Miasmatic Constitutional Materia Medica, Volume 6, to see if these that I have said can be confirmed by the data of the proving and clinical data from the Repertory and Materia Medica of Ghent. Let's go to the mental rubrics for the chapter Mind from the Repertory of Ghent. We've got a very important group of rubrics under the title Fastidious and Ailments After Fastidiousness. The main characteristic: fastidious, lean, withered, hungry, dyspeptic, bent forward individuals that are prematurely aged, yin, and stressed. Oversensitive to untidiness, fastidious, fault-finding, never contented. Affairs crowd upon him, causing insomnia after 3 a.m. Dreads business affairs. Conscientious about trifles. Occupation ameliorates. From overwork in fastidious businessmen or housekeeping affairs in fastidious women. Abuse of stimulants, tea, coffee, wine, in order to cope, or medicines. Ailments after anger, anxiety. This fastidiousness causes another group of symptoms: overloaded mentally, hard working, stressed, anxiety, overloaded mentally, confusion of mind, absent-mindedness, and so on. Overloaded emotionally, irritable, touchy, cannot be contradicted. Anger, excitement, senses acute, senses oversensitive, to slightest noise, starting, startled, restlessness, hurry, impatience. Then we have overloaded physically, nervous symptoms, neuralgias, neuralgic headaches, spasms, cramps, jerking, trembling. Because he is overloaded physically, he has his worse after eating, worse from spiritual liquors. These are the main characteristics that come out from this essence and psychological profile. Then we go to the general physical characteristics of Nux Vomica. If you have a person that is tensed on the psychological level, he will be also tensed concerning body. So we go to the rubrics from the chapter Generalities from the Repertory of Ghent, we have a great group that has to do with tension, sensitiveness in muscles, spastic personality, actions are turned in the opposite direction. Remember what I told you about constipation. Physical anxiety, nervous symptoms, constrictions, convulsions, tension pains, sensitiveness to noise. Then we have another group of physical characteristics that have to do with toxins, worse alcohol. Although he craves coffee in order to cope with his schedule, he is worse alcohol, coffee, tobacco, rich food, and drugs. Anything that makes him more toxified. He is already very toxified, and each thing that makes him more toxified then makes him worse. And worse, loss of fluids. If you are so tired, losing fluids is something that makes you even more worse. Then we have a group under the title Weakness. Worse motion, worse morning, unrefreshing sleep. If you are so stressed and hard working, you get weak at some time. Faintness, anemia, weakness, worse motion. Then we have cold. West cold 3. West cold air, especially at head, catches cold 3 from nose, and colds travel from nose to chest. Pains, tension pains. These are the most important physical characteristics of nux vomica. And then we go to diseases, to acute illnesses. What do you expect? Don't you expect that such a person that is very stressed and very hard working and tired, that he will have many acute conditions? Yes, nux vomica does have many great acute problems. That is, we've got a characteristic and intense pictures in many systems. We have vertigo and headache, nervous ones. We have sleeplessness, again from tension. Then we have problems with the peptic system, because the peptic system is the more sensitive system to stress. Pain stomach, vomiting, pain abdomen, constipation, diarrhea. And then we have the sensitivity of the respiratory system, coryza, hay fever, cough, nose. So you see, the unity of mind and body. You have to remember, constitutions is not just a homeopathic knowledge or a homeopathic theory or something that has practice application only to homeopathy and health. Constitutions is a very important, the most important theoretical discovery of homeopathy. It can because it affects the whole life and existence of the human being. Miasms and constitutions are the most important knowledge, because if you lessen these predispositions, lessen these influences to man, he gets more happy, more free, more healthy. If you let if the person doesn't realize how these things affect him, then he is lost. He goes against the flow of life. He violates the universal laws. And that's why constitutions are attachments, are passions, create passions and attachments to human beings. And we as individuals draw to us the certain constitution, passion and attachment and mayas that is in accordance with our free will. If my will is to do this wrong thing, then I draw to myself this miasmatic and constitutional influence, this passion, this attachment. And that's why I get ill and unhappy. Thank you.